Hey friends, hope you're well. New Mac apps are constantly being released, existing ones are being improved, and I just love that apps can dramatically improve your current Mac. So here are 12 incredible new Mac apps that will help you be more productive, protect your machine, get more value out of your Mac, and even, for example, improve your Mac's inbuilt speakers. And as usual, most of the featured apps in this video will be completely free for you to install, or at the very least come with a free trial. So let's jump right into the first app. The very first one is Notch Nook, and this one is seriously incredible. You have to check this one out. So once installed, you go over to the notch and you click it, and the notch will expand. So it will basically make the notch at the top more useful with a bunch of tools. So for example, it has Spotify here. It has a couple shortcuts that I've created over here. It has a webcam mirroring tool and also a quick glance at the calendar. It also has a tray here for you to install quick files, for example, where you need to transfer them or send them. But overall, it just makes your notch so much more useful. Bringing up the settings here, you can enable a bunch of functionality and set settings to your liking. You can even enable live activities here, so it basically mimics an iPhone's dynamic island. So Notch Nook just takes that wasted space up here and turns it into an engaging and usable space. If you prefer not to pay for apps, fear not, there are two similar free apps called Boring Notch and Notch Drop. I'll link both of these in the description box below, and actually I'll link all the featured apps below for your convenience. Next is Day Progress, a taskbar app. It's a small progress icon up here that looks like your battery, but it actually keeps track of the time remaining in your day. And essentially what it does is it just reminds you that, hey, your day is finite, don't waste your time. It's as simple as just setting up here. I've got the day range to Monday to Friday set at a specific time. And the icon you can actually change to various different shapes. You can show it flipped, and you can change the length. It's a very simple app icon, but I find it extremely useful because whenever I glance up the top, it sort of reminds me like, hey, I've only got 3 hours left in the day until your day should technically end. So yeah, I use this simply as a visual cue to stay motivated and make sure that I'm managing time more efficiently, because as Zig Ziglar says, if you don't plan your time, someone else will waste it for you. Next is simple but incredibly useful. It's called Cheat Sheet. It's another completely free app that lets you see all the shortcuts available by just holding the command button down, and then you'll see, in fact, the cheat sheet for this specific app. So let's say, you know, I'm in Figma and I want to know how to open up the dev mode. Well, there we go. It's up and D. So this will actually change if I open up to a different app like Google Chrome. I hold down cheat sheet, and you can see all the available cheats for, or shortcuts, I should say, for Google Chrome. This is a brilliant free app to get and download if you're looking to learn shortcuts and speed up your workflow really quickly. Next up is Boom 3D Audio, and this is an app that helps improve the audio on your Mac. So to enable it, you click the logo and then adjust the 3D surround sound to your liking with the sliders here and things like spatial audio effects. And what it does is it equalizes the sound to your Mac that you're using. You can also change the presets for yourself, like setting up certain presets for gaming, certain music genres. Basically, this is an EQ and compressor app for your Mac. If you've ever fiddled, for example, with TV speakers or soundbar settings, you'll know what I'm talking about. It is a great app if you want to tweak and improve the speakers on your Mac. Caffeine is another free and small menu bar app. This icon up at the menu bar here activates Caffeine, and basically it prevents your Mac from automatically going to sleep, and it can also dim the screen and start screensavers. This is just great if you need like continuous operation for a background task, avoiding interruptions during presentations or video calls, for example, and things like that. It's just useful to have up living on the menu bar. So next up is a project management software, monday.com, and for transparency, they're sponsoring this video segment. If you're looking to organize your business during during the new year, monday.com is the platform you need to save time, structure your business workflow, and collaborate with your team from a single spot. For example, the automation features are amazing in saving time for repetitive business tasks. I have one set up when a customer signs up for a workshop. Monday.com automation will automatically pull the email address associated and send an email with their name in the body of the message confirming the workshop details. Also, with a single click, teams can also create Monday.com dashboards to give them an entire snapshot of all the projects in one spot without sifting through endless emails and spreadsheets manually. These dashboards here track everything from project progress to team performance in real time. And if you have large teams working across multiple different platforms, Monday.com integrations can pull them all into one place, giving you and the team access to all your favorite software like Slack and Gmail in one place so everyone is conveniently updated with less effort on your team. So if you're looking to supercharge your team's productivity this year and keep your business super organized from the get-go, Monday.com could be what you need. My viewers can check out Monday.com for free through the link in the description box below. All right, so moving on, here's another app to keep up your MacBook sleeve, and it's called Popclip. When you are reading an article, for example, when you highlight a word or a sentence or a paragraph, Popclip will pop up with a few nifty options. You can, you know, do the usual search, cut, copy, paste, and the dictionary here will pop up and give you an explanation of whatever you highlighted. But basically, it's a pop-up that makes it much more convenient and faster for you to search what you want to do, cut, copy, paste. You might be thinking, well, you can easily do this by just highlighting a word and right-clicking, and then the whole selection will come up. But this pop-up tool makes it just that much more convenient and faster. And at the end of the day, that tiny bit of convenience stacks up over time. Now, have you ever wanted a light mode wallpaper and a dark mode wallpaper, or a morning wallpaper and an evening wallpaper that's outside of those Mac dynamic wallpapers? Well, this app here is called Umbra, and it does exactly that. It's a simple, lightweight app where you simply drag and drop your wallpapers in, and once you turn dark mode or light mode on off, it will switch between those two specific wallpapers. I think it's such a nice touch, and it mimics those dynamic wallpapers that we get from Mac, but it's a bit more customized. You're allowed to use your own wallpapers, and you can have a lot of fun with these. If you like these two wallpapers that I'm showing you right here, these are ones that I've created, and you can grab them for yourself below in the description box. Next up is Raycast, an insane stack of productive functions in a simple app. So normally you'd open up Mac Spotlight to search things with Command Spacebar, but Option Spacebar opens up Raycast, which is Spotlight on steroids for power users. For example, you can convert time zones by typing 11 p.m. AEDT to EST right there, and it'll convert it for you. You can't do this in Spotlight at the moment. You can even go into settings to set up extensions to better integrate apps like a password manager into the Raycast bar for easier access to all your passwords. And I love that it has a refined and appealing AI that makes it so simple to use. And it brands itself as the productivity tool macOS should have shipped with, which I kind of like. And after using it, I have to say that I agree. The next app is called Imazing Backups, and it's literally an amazing backup app. It's one of the first few apps that's able to both backup, store, and reopen your Mac and iPhone's messages, music, files, and data. This app can also schedule wireless automatic backups to external drives and even works across PCs and Macs. I actually found this app when I was looking for an app that was able to open up older iPhone backup files, and this was the only app that I was able to find that did this really well. So yeah, I recommend keeping this app up your sleeve. You never know when you might need it. Now, OnlyOffice here is a great free alternative to Microsoft Office for Mac if you don't want to pay an annual subscription to edit Word documents and spreadsheets locally on Mac. This is the app to get, I'd say, because it's pretty straightforward to use. And the best part about it is, let me bring up Microsoft Word just to show you. It looks essentially identical to Microsoft Word. I think it's the best free alternative that can open almost all sorts of Office documents and has a familiar user interface that's easy to pick up. And it's really simple and straightforward to use, as you can see here. It's completely free, doesn't have a subscription fee, and it also works perfectly well with Excel spreadsheets as well. So yeah, it's definitely an app to install onto all new Macs, or if you just want to save yourself some coin and start to use a free alternative, this is absolutely the Office document editor to get. So currently Google doesn't have a Mac compatible Google Calendar app, but I think I've found the solution. So if you use Google Calendar, you'll probably find this useful too. So go into Google Chrome and then to Google Calendar. Once you're there, click the three dots up here and then scroll all the way down to Cast, Save and Share and click Install Page as App. I did not know this was an actual feature and this is a game changer. Then go ahead and click the app and there you go. You'll now have Google Calendar in your dock and it'll open and operate as if it's a native app. This has been a game changer for me personally because I'm not a big fan of using Google Cal in Chrome. I like using calendars as an app and this has been a pretty decent workaround. Then finally, we have a pretty complicated app, but a pretty amazing one. It's called Crossover. And this app here allows you to run Windows specific applications and games right on your Mac. So basically when you run the app, it opens a Windows compatibility layer over your Mac. So it can run Windows only games like Counter-Strike 2 or a Windows app like Visual Studio right from your app. It's pretty wild playing high-end Windows games on a Mac Mini or a MacBook Air. It can be a little finicky to get up and running, but if you're interested and you have like an hour to spare, I'll leave a video on screen to a quick tutorial video that I created that will help you get this set up and you can literally start Windows gaming on your Mac. So yeah, which of the 12 Mac apps did you end up downloading? Let me know down in the comments. And if you made it to the very end of this video, comment the code word Macintosh and I'll give it a like. I'll drop a video here to more Mac apps that I think you'll love. And as always, thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video.